I've got a boo-boo on my woohoo.
A boo-boo on my woohoo.
Yes,
I'm going to guess a woohoo is in the vulval area.
Yes.
But a boo-boo, I am not so sure what that is.
I've got a lump.
A lump.
A lump
in the vulval area.
Yeah.
And how long has that been there for?
I first noticed I had like a pea-shaped lump about 4 years ago.
Okay.
And then 2 years ago, I noticed it kind of doubled in size. It's just awkward.
It's one of these things whenever we do have a skin condition or a lump or a bump in our kind of what we think of as our private parts, because one hand, it's hidden from everybody, so nobody's seeing it.
Yeah.
But on the other hand, it's very annoying, it's very uncomfortable, and it interferes with everything that we do on a daily basis. And what about with your husband as well? Does it affect your kind of like sex life or anything like that?
I'm aware of it. I'm just grateful I'm actually married and very happily married. I don't know how someone could be single and contemplating getting close to somebody with this.
How does it make you feel? I can tell by your face.
I just hate it.
Okay, right, let's have a look at this boo-boo. Let's have a wee peek. Oh, yeah. Isn't that a very cute one?
Not my words, but yeah.
Oh, it is. It is. So this is a lipoma. They come in all different kind of shapes and kind of textures, but this is a lipoma that's a fairly soft lipoma, but still will have a capsule that's holding it in this olive-like shape. And it's on the part of the vulva that we call the labia majora.
Okay.
Why did you get it? We don't know. Sometimes trauma can set off lipomas, but it's not really an area of...
I did fall off my bike 5 years ago.
Did you?
And landed awkwardly, yeah. I lived on a barrier island in America, and everyone rides beach bikes, and it's really cool to ride with your hands down by your side. It didn't end well, and it did hurt. 5 years ago, that was...
Yeah, so a year after this happened.
So I suspect that's probably been what it was. It's a bit like the fat responding and making an airbag. You know, it's had an injury once.
Yeah.
So it's like, right, I'm going to protect myself.
So it is going to get bigger.
It would just keep getting bigger.
Oh, OK. Can it go?
It can go.
Oh, you can get rid of it.
Yeah. You want to do that?
Oh, God, yes. Please, please, please. Yeah.
So just let me know if you feel anything sharp or sore or uncomfortable, okay? Anything sharp or sore at all if I touch along there?
No, everything's good.
Perfect. I can see Olive.
She's not green.
Oh, good.
That's a very good colour of lipoma. We're not doing any cutting or anything now. All we're doing is just
teasing it round. Okay, so I'm going to squeeze it and it should pop out now. Are you ready?
Yeah. Here we go. And there is Olive!
No, that quick!
It does actually look like a little baby, a tiny little head.
Oh, stop it! Stop it!
So now we're just going to tease her off, and all in a lovely kind of like one little capsule, bringing it off nice and easily. So hopefully should not cause you any problems with it coming back in the future. There. Would you like to see it? There she is.
Oh my God, that is so big.
Okay, so we'll just pop a few wee stitches in.
It's gonna take longer to stitch up and get out.
Yeah.
I just can't thank you enough, I really can't.
You can hardly see it.
And let it be a lesson to everyone to always put your hands on the handles when riding a bike.
Exactly. Don't think you're so cool.
Last little stitch. Okay, so this was Olive before.
Oh, it's horrible.
This is her gone.
Oh.
So this is the scar line, and these are the wee stitches in place. Super tiny. So that was the outline
Thank
of Olive.
You.
Oh, my pleasure.
I'm so happy.
My pleasure.
I'm so happy. Sorry, I'm just.
Hey there. How are you?
It's all gone.
Oh.
It was so much bigger than you thought it was going to be. I feel amazing. I feel like a stone lighter. I just feel like myself.
It just feels like someone's taken a potato peeler to it and taken my skin off. Oh, God.
Oh. My condition is called Hailey-Hailey disease.
This is the worst I've seen it over the last few days.
My skin is splitting.
Oh.
Under both of my breasts and in my groin.
Oh, it's a funny colour. And it's got a bit of an odour to it as well.
Elaine's had her condition for 35 years. The creams calm it down sometimes, and then it's back with a vengeance.
Cover that bit there, because it's really sore.
There isn't many men that would actually do what my husband Terry does for me.
OK, can we have a little look?
Yes, certainly.
Let's see, so we'll hold it. Yeah, that's perfect. Oh, yeah. So you can actually see where the skin has thickened up, and then the skin cells are just coming away, and they're causing these little splits that you can see in the skin. Now, what I need to do is see the groin area.
So we're going to make you do yoga.
OK. It's mainly up in here, I get it.
OK, yeah. Not as bad as the underbreast area, but you can see it's red, yeah, for sure. And then the same thing in here. Oh, it's a bit worse on this side. Undoubtedly, this is your Hailey-Hailey disease. There's a couple of different things I'd quite like to think about doing for you. One of them is a treatment called naltrexone. Now, that is a tablet medicine, and you take that medicine every day.
OK.
The medicine works by trying to strengthen the bonds between the skin cells in these areas and calm the inflammation. What do you think about that?
I'm getting a treatment plan to help me with it. I am really, really chuffed and excited, and I can just feel my body smiling.
You are smiling, and even your cheeks are smiling all the way up to here.
Yeah.
I can do those botulinum toxin injections today.
I could cuddle you.
Oh, good. OK, perfect. Now, each one of these is going to be a wee bit stingy. But not too stingy, hopefully.
That's OK.
I'll start here.
Just a deep breath for me.
Wee scratch, well done.
It is very stingy.
You're doing really good.
Very well, because given that this is sore for even me to touch and I'm now sticking needles in it, you're doing amazing. OK. OK, good. Well done for being so brave.
So I just persevere.
Grin and bear it.
Yeah, I'm just looking at Rosie's eyes.
I know, they're very nice to look at, aren't they?
Yeah, she's got pretty eyes.
So the last time you came to see me, you were in a bit of a state, really.
I was, yeah. It was literally unbearable. I wasn't living a life, I was just existing.
And so how do you feel whenever you wake up every day?
It's the first thing I actually do. Lift up my breasts and I think, gosh, yeah, that is different. There's no pain. And I can actually wear a bra.
Oh, brilliant. Where... You can see how chuffed you are.
I am. It is. It's just like I'm a different person. I can live my life now.
Yeah. Do you mind if I have a look? Is that OK?
Yeah, no, that's fine.
OK, well, we'll let you get into your gown then, OK?
OK, thank you.
OK, Elaine, can I have a look at the areas under the breast to begin with?
Sure.
Is that OK?
Yeah, no problem.
Oh, my goodness. What a difference.
I know, it's amazing, isn't it?
It really, really is just fantastic. Look at that, Motti.
Yeah. How smooth is that, Elaine?
I know.
And not red, not angry. That is really great. Absolutely brilliant. OK, let's have a look at the other side. It's so much better. Now, what I need to do is see the groin area. Okay, so this area still needs more work. So I'm going to adjust your medications to get this up a little bit higher for you.
Okay.
Because we're aiming for clear, and we can see that it's possible. So overall, this is going really very well. In a really short period of time, you've gone from 30 years of it being a nightmare to this part actually even being clear.
I'm really happy. I really am that it's starting to work. And I'm not in pain under my breasts now like I was. I just can't stop smiling that after 30 plus years, something has actually worked. I'm just so happy and my confidence is growing. I never thought this day would come.